يعني abandoning joining the ties. Abandoning joining the ties. And he say, وَهَذِهِ وَاجِبَاتِ. These are from the obligations. These are from the obligations. And joining the ties, barakallahu fikum, it is not that you are yani joining with those who are joining with you. You checking on your family, on your kinfolk, those who only checking on you. But rather those who are not checking on you. This is the true reality of silatul rahim, joining the ties. Meaning you calling those who don't call you. You check on those who are not checking on you. But if you merely just check on them because they're checking on you, this is not a ibadah no more. But you check in those who, barakallah, if that's not you picking up your phone to call them, hey, uncle, how you doing? Or hey, cousin, how you doing? And the likes of this, they're not doing it. Now, this is, barakallah, fikum, joining the ties. The shahafidahullah, he say, and these matters, they are from the wajibat. Birrul walidain is from the wajibat. Right? Hey, where is dalil? What's the dalil that birrul walidain is from the wajibat? A verse. Not the meaning of the verse, a verse. To show that birrul walidain, it is from the wajibat, from the obligation. Ismail? Ahsanta. وَقَدَ رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُ إِلَّا إِيَّا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Surah Muhammad. Isra, Ahsanta, very good. What's the next verse? Khalil? What's the next verse? Another verse. Hassan. Adam. Yeah, Luqman, very good. Say the verse. Memorize it by tomorrow. Right, this is on Surah. That's not Luqman though. فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفْ. This is in Surah Isra. Isra too. Very good. But the verse he's referring to was what? In Surah Al-Luqman. When he say, فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا وَصَاحِبُهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا. فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا. If they call you to shirk, do not obey them or follow them. But وَصَاحِبُهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا. But be with them with kindness. Even if they're calling you to disbelief. Look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, even if they're calling you to disbelief, don't obey them in that. But still, وَصَاحِبُهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا. And be with them in the most kind ways. Now this is about the person is calling you to that which is the most hated to Allah. أعظم ما نهى الله إيش الشرك. Now your parents call you to shirk, what do? You say no to that. But still you are what? You are to be dutiful to them. Now that shows the importance of what? Obeying one's parents. So the Shahafidahullah, he said that this is from the wajibat. فَمَنْ تَرَكَهَا نَقَصَ إِيمَانُهُ. Whoever abandons it, then his iman is deficient. Whoever abandons it, his iman is deficient. And it is from the kabair, right? When the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned about the sab'a al-mubiqat, he mentioned about what? Huququl walidain. To be barakallahu fikum abusive in one's parents. To be transgressing in regard to the rights of one's parents. This is from the mubiqat, from those destructive sins that the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned. And he said, وَكَانَ عَاصِيًا بِتَرْكِ الْوَاجِبِ. So a person like this, he is sinful, right? By way of abandoning something that is an obligation. فَيَكُونُ عَاصِيًا إِمَّا بِتَرْكِ الْوَاجِبِ وَإِمَّا بِفِعْلِ مُحَرَّمٍ. So the person will become someone of, يعني, عاصي, a transgressor, either by abandoning an obligation or by doing an action of impermissibility. وَعَلَى كُلِّ حَال. At any rate, لَا يَخْرُجُ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ. At any given case in regard to this, He is not to be declared a disbeliever. He is not to be declared a disbeliever. طيب فهمتم؟ He is not to be declared a disbeliever. He is not to be exited out from al-Iman, from belief. وَإِنَّمَا يَكُونُ مُؤْمِنًا. And this is a good line to underline. This is a good sentence to underline and memorize. وَإِنَّمَا يَكُونُ مُؤْمِنًا نَاقِصُ الْإِيمَانِ. He is a believer, but his belief is deficient. وَإِنَّمَا هُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ. He is a believer, but his belief is deficient. He is still a believer. Now the person, you find him on the street, he drinking some khamr, but 2 minutes ago he prayed with you. Are you going to call you a kafir? Or the person that you pray with him Jum'ah, and you find him on the corner, you know what I'm saying, doing his thing, are you going to call him a kafir? La wa kalla. But you would say he's a believer, but his iman is what? Is deficient. Na'am Allah. Yeah. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. He said, how do we put together the fact that if a person make mockery of the deen, he is a disbeliever, but if he doesn't take care of his parents, he is, because the ruling came in the Quran. The ruling came in the Quran as far as the one that did what? That made mockery. It was sarahata. So he mentioned, Hafidhullah, he said, upon any rate, وَعَلَى كُلِّ حَالٍ لَا يَخْرُجُ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ. At any given rate, this person that committed a major sin, he is not a disbeliever. But the issue is, he say, وَإِنَّمَا يَكُونُ مُؤْمِنًا نَاقِصُ الْإِيمَانِ. He is a believer, that his iman, his belief is what? Is deficient. So he's still a believer, but his belief is deficient. It is not complete. He said, هذا مذهب أهل السنة والجماعة خلافا للخوارج والمعتزلة الذين يكفرون مرتكب الكبائر. فالخوارج يكفرونه ويخرجونه من الدين، والمعتزلة يخرجونه من الدين لكن لا يدخلون في الكفر، وإنما يقولون هو في منزلة بين منزلتين، لا هو مؤمن ولا كافر. The Shaykh Hafidhahullah say that this is the methodology of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, meaning the person that does a major sin, he is still a believer, but his belief is deficient. He said, this is the methodology of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Right? This is the methodology of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Now, I want few other names, right, of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Zaid, another name of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Another name, when you hear it, you will know that this is referred to Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Naam, Abu Rahmah. Ahsanta, Ahlul Hadith. Very good. Another name. Firqatun Najiya. Firqatun Najiya. Firqatun Najiya. Najaw min Aish. قالها من؟ قالها من؟ Who are you?
Huh?
والأدب أيضا. ضعيف في العلم والأدب. عمر, but yes, فرقة الناجية. فرقة الناجية ابن تيمية رحمه الله say that they are saved from bid'ah in this life and saved from the hellfire يوم القيامة. اكتب هذا. So you will not say your name in regard to this no more. السلفية, yes, أهل السلف, سلف الصالح. What else? أهل الأثر, very good. طائفة المنصورة, another one. خليل, إسماعيل, الغرباء. الغرباء, that's a description. أهل that's a description, yes. What else? What is known, بارك الله فيكم. الجماعة, 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 right? الجماعة, just الجماعة, right? The word الجماعة, بارك الله فيك. Not in reference to these criminals, جماعة التبليغ. It's not what we're talking about, right? We're talking about الجماعة, as the hadith of Ibn Mas'ud. He said, الجماعة ما وافق الحق ولو كنت وحدك. That the jama'ah, the body, is the one that is in line with the truth, even if he is by himself. Even if he is by himself. This is the body. So he mentioned, عند أهل السنة والجماعه, with the people of أهل السنة والجماعه, he say, خلافا للخوارج, in opposition of the خوارج. In opposition of the خوارج. Who was the head of the خوارج? Or the first one that did khuruj? Omar? Okay, there is no reason that these things we're asking, we all are not jumping to say. Abba Musa, I forgot about you, man. Huh? Abdullah? Very good. Let me get the name first. Yes. Dhul Khuwaisira. Dhul Khuwaisira. Look, when they have Khawarij, make a circle and put Dhul Khuwaisira. So you will not forget it. Write it down. And you will not, next time when you pass by Khawarij, just put a circle, like in a what you call it, a arrow, and put Dhul Khuwaisira. When you have the Khawarij, just make a circle. Put Zul, Zul Khuwaisira. Next time you ain't gonna forget it. Right? Put Zul Khuwaisira. The first one that Barakallah, if you can renegade against the Waliyul Amr, which is the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he mentioned Hafidhahullah. You want it? Oh, Jazakallah. He say, in opposition of the madhab of the Khawari and the Mu'tazila, those who they declare the person embarking upon a major sin to be a disbeliever. He said the Khawarij, that they will declare him to be disbeliever and they will take him out from the fold of Islam. Amma al-Mu'tazila, that they will take him out of the religion, walakin la yadkhulunahu fil kufr, they will not establish him in disbelief. Yet they took him out from belief, but they will not place him in disbelief. Innama yaquluna, what they will say is, huwa fi manzila, he is at a position, bayna manzilatayn, between these two positions, ayy al-kufr wal-iman. And the Shafidahullah, he say, meaning, la huwa mu'min, meaning he is not a believer, wala kafir, and he is not a disbeliever. Now the question is this, if a person is not a believer, he is not a disbeliever, what name you going to give him? Huh?
Nobody.
What is between iman and kufr? Imma shakiran wa imma kafura. This is these two. Whether the person is grateful, ayyi, from tawheed, or he is from those who negate the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his oneness.